guys, and here I am with another Halloween makeup tutorial. Today is Annabelle, the creepy doll or the murderer, as I hope you understood. I leave you to the tutorial because this is quite disgusting, the blood in my mouth and these contact lenses are really uncomfortable. I hope you're gonna like it and make sure you sleep well tonight, and I'm gonna meet you in your dreams. Start by covering my brows with some pretty stick in different layers. Now I'm gonna start the base. I'm gonna take a white color from my Supra palette, and you can take any cream color white, and I'm gonna apply on the places we're gonna highlight. So it's in the middle of the forehead, middle of the nose, on the top of the cheeks, and in the middle of the chin. Now, from my Krylon concealer palette, I'm taking a color to cover my brows, and I'm just gonna pat the color on the top of my brows and set it with some translucent powder. I'm using MAC Prep and Prime. You can use any translucent powder you have. The skin color, I'm using Max Factor Foundation Lasting Performance in number 100 with the Duo Fiber Brush by MAC. This is a number 130, and Annabelle is a vintage doll and she's quite pale with a little bit of green going on in her skin. So I'm trying to build up that color. Always make sure you do more than one color, so it's gonna look more three-dimensional, it's not gonna look flat. I'm putting the color also on my eyes, and now I'm mixing these two colors, always from my Supra palette, is the white and the military green. So you have this kind of light green color, and with the stipple sponge I'm gonna stipple it around the face, concentrating especially at the edges, also bring it onto the neck. And once we finish stippling this color, which is gonna make look Annabelle more like a zombie like, we're gonna set everything with Prep and Prime translucent powder. I'm gonna add some more green color around. Always, this is a layering process, so the more layer you do, the more your doll is gonna look three-dimensional. So we're always repeating the same step, adding the color wherever you need it, and then we go back and set everything with powder. Now for my Scream Face palette, I'm gonna take a grey matte eyeshadow and I'm gonna start creating the structure of the face. So if you smile, you see your cheeks are gonna be more rounded. So I'm gonna start from the side of my nose and I'm gonna make my cheeks more rounded, bringing on the top the shape, like almost in the middle of my cheeks. I'm using an angled brush, and after applying the color, I'm using a bullet brush just to blend the color so it looks softer, it's not gonna be too harsh. I'm doing the same thing under my chin, so it's gonna make more rounded, and I'm drawing a line in this way. So we're almost gonna make two triangles, one at the top and one in the bottom part of the face. So this is gonna give the impression of a fake smile. I'm bringing the grey eyeshadow also at the top of my brows, which I covered before. Now, always with the grey matte eyeshadow and the soft contouring brush, I'm gonna shape the face. So I'm applying the color under my jawline, on the neck as well, to create more depth. And also into the temples. And now I'm also shading under my nose. I'm always using the same eyeshadow and the soft blending brush. And I'm also gonna intensify the lines I created around my face. I'm now gonna draw the brows, and I'm using a black aqua color by Krylon. You can use any face painting, body painting color as long as it's black. And I'm using a fine liner brush by MAC. This is the 210, so it's gonna give us really fine lines. And I'm trying to recreate Annabelle brows, which are kind of 20s brows. If you are scared to make a mess, you can also sketch the shape of your brows before with a nice shadow, like a soft brown, and then you go on the top with black. Now I'm drawing some lines around the face with the duo fiber brush and some brown color, always from my aqua color palette, and this is gonna give us the impression of like a vintage doll, because if you look at the skin of Annabelle, it's quite there's lots of texture going on, different colors, and this is gonna help us to recreate the effect. And after I put the color, I'm gonna blend it with the stipple sponge. To recreate these dolly eyes, I'm gonna make them bigger, and I'm using a white pencil from MAC. This is fascinating. I'm putting it in the waterline and slightly under as well. Now I'm using black track from MAC. You can use any black gel eyeliner, and I'm drawing a line under my eyes after the white pencil and blending it with a soft brush. I'm swapping back to the aqua color, black, and also with the eyeliner brush I used before, I'm gonna draw some fake lashes under the eyes, and to do this I'm always referring to the picture of Annabelle I have in front of me, and you can see some lashes under her eyes, so this is what I'm gonna create. Always with the black track, I'm applying it on the top of my eyes to recreate Annabelle eyeshadow, so I'm gonna try to make a round shape on the top of my eyes, and I'm gonna fill in with black. To set everything, I'm gonna use a black eyeshadow on the top, and I'm also gonna, this is gonna also help me blending the color. So once you finish the eyes, I'm gonna take a wet wipe and I'm gonna make the shape rounder, because I went too far blending, and I'm covering the clean part with some foundation. We're gonna draw some fake lashes also at the top of the eyes, just in the corners as Annabelle has, and we do the same process on the other side of the eye. To recreate the gap Annabelle has between her eyes, top and bottom part, I'm gonna use an Ila Maska white eyeliner and just applying it in the gap, as you see here. Now for some falsies, I'm gonna use some MAC eyelashes, number 35, which are quite dolly-like, and after applying mascara, I'm gonna stick them on with some duo glue. Now I'm using a limited edition MAC blush. It's called Hair Blooming Cheek. They don't do it anymore. It's just a fuchsia color. And then on the top, I'm blending another red blusher or eyeshadow, just to make everything more three-dimensional, and just blend in rounded motion. Now I'm gonna stipple some more brown around the face. It's time for some cracks now, because as I said, Annabelle is a vintage doll, so she's quite old and she's got some cracks on the neck, in the middle of the chin, and there's no creepy doll without any cracks. I'm always using the aqua color and the fine eyeliner brush. We are intensifying the shadow between Annabelle's brows and eyes, so basically I'm going over my actual brows. And to intensify the color of the lines I drew across my face, I'm using a dark brown eyeshadow. Now it's time for the lips. She's got quite pointed lips, and I'm using cherry pencil by MAC. You can use any red pencils. And I'm gonna fill the whole mouth with this color. And then on the top, I'm gonna apply a red lipstick. She has got some shading around the mouth as well, so I applied some other black track and then I blended with a soft brush, just to create the illusion of a shade. Now I'm gonna apply some makeup blood in scab with a stipple sponge, just on the top of the cheek, because that's what she has in the picture, and also a bit on the nose, so that's how it looks like. She also has one drop of blood coming from one eye, and I'm gonna add some blood in the mouth and around. I'm gonna pass now to the hair. I'm gonna stick a fake fringe I bought on eBay, and I'm just gonna put my hair in braids. We're gonna add some blood between the teeth, and this is quite disgusting, but it's gonna
Ciao,
look more
vuoi
scary.
giocare con me?
That's it. I really hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial. If you do, please give me a thumbs up. It means a lot to me, and especially don't forget to share the video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. I'll see you to the next one. Bye bye.